Get ready to match the stars from the Love Boat, Fred Grandy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Laverne and Shirley, Leslie Easterbrook, McLean Stevenson, and from Harper Valley TVA, Fanny White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star match game, Gene Reger.
What'd you say?
The Star Money Big Studded Match Game.
Really?
Yeah.
That's very kind of you to notice.
Yeah.
Oh. What are you wearing there, Leslie?
Well, I don't know.
Looks like you're graduating from college. It looks like a graduation gown, doesn't
it's cute.
It?
Cute. Joan Crawford.
I like it.
Throw away.
The hat, I guess.
A mortarboard, no, yeah. No, I think it's very attractive.
Looks like you have shoulder pads on.
Well, it's my third day, you know.
All right. Let's not embarrass her now. She's very attractive and a nice lady, too. Let's say hello to Roger Faniff and Jeannie DeBates here. Roger lives in San Diego, right?
Right, sir.
Who gave you the good luck sign on your lapel there?
My little boy, Tommy, gave me that for good luck, and that's exactly what it says. Good luck, and I hope I have it.
It's a peanuts thing, is it?
Yeah, the Red Baron shaking hands with, I guess it's Lucy.
Ah. How old is your boy?
He's 5 years old.
Well, that's very perceptive of him. Now, Jeannie here is a student at Long Beach University, is it?
Long Beach State, right.
Long Beach State, yeah. And what is she studying?
I study art.
Art.
Mm-hmm. Are drawing you gonna be and painting.
You're going to be an artist, is that it?
Well, I would like to be, but I'll probably never make a living that way.
That's what they said about Picasso. All right, let's see where we are. We're in the middle of game number two, right? Game one, round two. And since you're ahead, Roger, you have to go first.
Okay, I'll try a B this time.
Here it is. Harry said, my wife is such a rotten cook. After she makes hamburger helper, I need blank helper. You don't like All right, Roger. Harry said, my wife is such a rotten cook. After she makes hamburger helper, I need blank helper.
Whoa.
Intestinals, the only thing that comes into my... to help my inside.
What did he
help
say?
Help his inside.
Yeah, that's the only thing that came to mind.
Intestinal?
Intestinal helper.
What an odd answer.
Yes. What'd you say, Fred?
I said milk of magnesia helper.
Milk of magnesia helper is good. Brett?
Oh, darling, this woman really couldn't cook. He needed paramedic helper.
Paramedic.
Now, this could be a match. I hate to say that it gets the judges nervous and the tension builds.
Yeah, I can feel it.
Digestive helper.
Digestive helper. Now, I guess that because the digestive helper would include the entire alimentary canal. And all he said was intestinal.
Thank you, doctor.
Alimentary canal. Isn't he smart?
Begins at the mouth. Well, let's not go into that. Harry said, my wife is such a rotten cook. After she makes hamburger helper, I need blank helper.
Close neighbor.
You don't play. Close it is.
Oh. See, when it says don't write here, that means you matched in a previous round. And it was a nice try, but it would have not worked anyway, Raj.
I mean, this is... Learn to read as well as write, it'd be fine.
All right, McLean. You're up.
I think this could be a match.
I hope so.
Okay, because I said stomach. Hold it. Your intestines are in your stomach, but down here at the bottom, in little letters, is the word gas.
Wow!
Well, could have fooled me. What do you say?
I say this may be a match. You need a plumber's helper.
Oh, that was so close, Fanny. I can't tell you how close that was. All right, Roger, two for you. Now, Jeannie, you need two to tie, three to win. I have a match game TV guide listing.
Uh-oh.
Friday night, Channel 95, Barretta. And the little synopsis of the story is, Barretta is pursued by the Humane Society after he is seen in a public park blanking his bird. Jeannie, Match Game TV Guide listing, Friday night, Channel 95, Beretta. Beretta's pursued by the Humane Society after he's seen in a public park blanking his bird.
Eating?
Eating his bird. All right. What do you say to that, Fred?
Before you eat the bird, you gotta pluck the bird.
Right, plucking his bird.
Get sick from eating a feathery bird and need digestive helper.
That's true.
Oh, I'm sick of it.
What's sick of it?
Every day, every way, we keep matching my drawing, plucking.
And she's not even stealing from you, is she?
No. Huh. Are you stealing from me?
A boring answer, feeding.
Feeding his bird. Well, that would not be a criminal offense, Charles. Leslie, Beretta's pursued by the Humane Society after he's seen in a public park blanking his bird.
This is disgusting, I know it. Kissing.
Kissing?
Kissing his bird.
Can you get arrested for that? All right,
McClane. According to who you're kissing.
Now, if I don't match, it's bye-bye, Jeannie, for one game.
Huh? That's it, right.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Well, bye-bye, Jeannie.
Goodbye, Jeannie.
Oh, no.
Roger wins the game. What did Fanny have?
Pulling the feathers off.
Pulling the feathers off. Come on, Roger, bud. Right there on the blue dot, if you would, please. Now, over here. Yeah, face that way. That's it. Now, Jeannie... We'll see you a little bit later. We're going to wheel this thing around here, and you'll be back for game number two in a little while, right?
Okay.
Okay, goodbye, Jeannie.
Bye-bye.
Now, we'll be back in a minute or so to see what happens after this and see how much money he's going to win. Okay, if you're ready, we're ready. You ready?
I sure am.
Yeah. Oh. We have pulled the studio... turn around, Raj. We have pulled the studio audience and write down your best answer to this. Put on blank. Put on blank. Now, if you look over the stars, the ones who are trying to get your attention probably have answers. The ones who are hiding under the desk don't have answers.
Okay, I'll try Fanny.
You will?
I sure will.
Oh, good.
Oh, yeah. He thought he was going to get a little bonus.
Something Brett hears quite often. Put on your clothes.
Put on your clothes. There's one.
Okay, McClane.
Okay, put on a happy face.
Yeah! All right.
Fred.
Put on your shoes. I even wrote it down so I'd remember it. Put on the door.
Your parents spend all that money sending you to Harvard, and you come up with put on your shoes?
Well, if I hadn't gone to Harvard, I probably just would have said, put on your shoe.
Oh, right. Now, those are the answers. You got put on your shoes, put on a happy face, and put on your clothes. Do you want one of those, or have you got a better idea in your head?
Put on your clothes.
Really?
Right.
Okay, put on your clothes is what he
wants. They've been wrong before, Roger.
Right, let's see if it's up there. May we see the bottom one, please? Put on your coat. That's part of your clothing, isn't it? But it's got to be exact here. The next one reads, put on a smile. That is a good one, yeah. Now, the last chance for put on your clothes. Here we go. Oh, happy face. McLean's answer, yeah. Gosh, I'm sorry about that, Roger. He struck out altogether here. You didn't get anything.
Tell you what, Gene, since what? It was mine and he didn't get anything, I'll give him $500 of my own money.
You will. Hey, let's hear it from McClane. What a good sport he is.
If he will sell me his 5-year-old son.
Deal?
No deal.
Okay.
All right,
Roger, let's get your opponent, Jeannie DeBates, back here for game number two. Welcome back, Jeannie. Okay. Hello, Jeannie.
Hello.
You ready?
Sure am.
All right. He wasn't quite ready for it. You want A or B, Jeannie?
I'll take B, please.
What's it say here? The psychiatrist said, my last patient is really wacko. He's the only man in the world who likes to walk down the street in mentally undressed blanks. A weirdo. Sure. How's a college kid doing up here? About ready? We are. Psychiatrist said my last patient is really wacko. He's the only man in the world who likes to walk down the street and mentally undress blanks.
Men? Other men?
Other men. That's her answer. All right, Fred, what do you say to this?
This may be a match. I said Jack Lord. Oh, I hope he doesn't find out.
Apparently it's not a match. What do you say?
No, I said, don't write letters to me, please. Nuns.
Nuns. Hello, Charles.
Hiya, kid. I said store window dummy.
Very good one. Only man in the world who likes to walk down the street and mentally undress blanks.
The opposite of other men, himself.
Himself?
Yes.
Oh.
Whoa, walks down the street. That.
Says, how would I look?
That's interesting.
Yes, it is.
Ooh, I like it.
Yeah. Yes, sir, McLean.
What's so weird about that?
I know what you look like.
I couldn't think of what those things are called, so I call them store model things.
Couldn't think of mannequins. Yes.
Mannequins, right.
All right.
This is so easy. If I don't match it, I'll go out with the first man who asks me, no matter what he looks like. I didn't match!
Mannequins in store windows. All right, now, let's see what we have for Roger. Well, we don't have anything for you right now. What we have is a commercial for America.
And here again, the star of our show, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, John.
Right?
My turn.
Ready?
Ready.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Yes.
Dumb Donald is really dumb.
How dumb is he?
He thinks a tuba is a stethoscope for blank. I can't even talk anymore.
Dumb Donald is so dumb, he thinks it's a tuba is a stethoscope
for blank.
That's hard to say, huh?
Yeah.
Stethoscope for blank.
Miss Leslie, you ready, honey? All right. Dumb Donald is really dumb, Roger. He thinks a tuba is a stethoscope for blank.
For the throat. To analyze the throat.
For what?
The throat.
You really missed it.
I really blew it, yeah.
You don't understand it, do you?
Not really, not totally, but
you see, a stethoscope is a small device, you know, the doctor
That's
puts
right.
in his ears. Right, and it's got a small bell-like listening device for the heart and the lungs and all that. Now, a tuba, let's say it's an enormous instrument, isn't it?
That's right.
So, who or what would that be a stethoscope for, is the question. You still don't understand.
I still not.
Yeah.
He's not alone.
I quit. To hell with this. I'm getting out of here. I've been doing this show too long anyway. I guess I better go on with it. Fred, show him a good answer, and if you don't, I'm going to belch in the mouth.
Orson Welles.
Oh. Any large animal such as Mr. Welles. What do you say?
Well, you know, this is an animal we used to use quite frequently in the early days. The Jolly Green Giant.
Hey,
there's another
again.
One. Yeah.
Very good.
King Kong.
Another good. Any now large person. Now you get it.
Now it's too late.
I know.
He thinks a tuba is a stethoscope for...
Giant majorettes.
Giant majorettes?
A marching band, you know. The yeah. Boom, pop, pop,
right.
Boom, pop.
Oh, dear. Yeah.
She and Roger should get together.
That's right.
Yeah.
We could come back as a contestant.
Bless her heart.
Did you understand it?
I did, and it looks to me, sport fans, like we're in for a big dumb-off between Jeannie Debates and Roger Faniff. Stay tuned. Could be a biggie. I put Orson Welles, Jack Lord, cross those out, and then put elephants.
Elephants! Yay! All right, Fanny.
I'd like to discuss something with you.
Yes, please.
I sit here and I hear them announce big money to match game.
Right.
There's something missing in my checks.
We haven't. Oh, in your checks.
Is that for the contestant?
That's right.
Oh, not for a...
Right.
How do you get on this show as a contestant?
You want to be a contestant?
Yeah.
Why don't you trade seats with her, Raj?
No, I said elephants.
Elephant. Good answer.
Well, here we go to round two, and as you can see, the score is tied, right? And since she went first last time, you go first this time. That's what happens when we have a tie.
Okay, B.
B it is.
I'm so excited.
Me too. Yeah. I wonder what sweater McLean will wear tomorrow.
Now, he wore the red one earlier in the week.
I know I'm wearing it now.
Oh, that you're wearing it now, right.
Didn't wear a red sweater
Listen,
earlier in the week.
Maybe. Maybe she'll let you wear this.
You want shoulder pads?
I wore it last night when we beat Birmingham High School 36-12. That's a bad joke. That's lovely.
All right, here we go. At the... At the watchmaker shop, Trudy said, I'll tell you why I'm not going to let that guy fix my watch. The only tool in the shop is a blank. The only tool in the watchmaker shop is a blank. Watchmaker shop, Trudy said, I'll tell you why I'm not going to let that guy fix my watch. The only tool in the shop is a blank.
This one I understand. A hammer. Yeah! Yeah!
Bravo!
I guess we just have to keep it simple from now on, don't we? No tricky stuff anymore, nothing, no three-syllable words or anything like that.
Boy, I'm sure glad you simplified these questions.
Yes.
I was really getting worried.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Jacuzzi.
Yeah, well,
all right.
He sure understood it, didn't he? All right, Brett.
I guess I should go back to making the rope-soled shoes, right, Mr.
Yes,
Rayburn?
Yes, indeed. Weaving the baskets.
Oh, Roger, it's me and you every step of the way, babe. Hammer.
That's not hammer, that's Hamer.
Right.
That's Rusty Hamer from the Richmond for Daddy show. That's not a match.
These people are so charming. Hammer.
All right. That's two for Roger. I'll tell you why I'm not going to let that guy fix my watch. The only tool in the shop is a...
Hammer.
Hammer. Three for him, I can't believe. He's on a roll.
I know. I
Slow
understood
him down
it, too.
A little. You did understand it?
Yeah.
Good.
Jacuzzi. Axe.
Axe, huh? All right. Well, that's good. Axe, what do you say?
Well, I'm trying to hammer.
Right. You got it.
Four for him.
You got some catching up to do. Let's see if you do it after this for you. Listen, we don't have time to do another question. I hope you'll both have the courage to show up tomorrow, because we ain't going to be here. Listen, are we coming back tomorrow?
Yes,
yeah,
I am.
Yeah, sure we are.
We are?
Yep. Jeannie DeBates could make the comeback of the year. Get five of those lights lit up and win big bucks. Let's all tune in and watch.
Okay. Well,
here we are.
What do you want to do now, Marty?
I bet you'd kill for his putty joke now, wouldn't you, with all his time left over?
Sure.
I was drawing fruit. See the pretty fruit?
Yeah, that's a banana, grapes, and an apple.
But we're I can't figure out how to get it in the bowl. Well, that's 9 seconds. Someone
right.
else is...
Put him in water.
All right. You're on for 20 seconds. Go. Yeah. Listen, this pretty lady is on a show called
Laverne and Shirley.
And we'll look forward to seeing her and look forward to seeing Fanny on Harper Valley PTA. And I'm Gene Rayburn. Join us next
time
for
the Match
Game.
Sure, don't mention my
show. Oh,
love
both.
See if you ever work it again.
Right. Oh, right.
Today's contestants will also receive Kraft Black Hawk Extra Lean Hams, a low smoked over genuine hickory. Three distinct flavors, hickory smoke, honey glaze, barbecue glaze. From across the Pacific comes Hawaiian Tropic, natural tanning lotions and oils, plus this Hawaiian Tropic clothes, Hawaiian Tropic, the tan of the islands. Minwax finishes the beautified wood indoors for years, now Minwax goes outdoors. Get your home ready for weather and wear of exterior wood finished by Minwax. When you've got anything that sticks to squeaks, reach for WD-40. Makes things work smoother, last longer. Do it yourself with WD-40.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. This program is edited for broadcast.